Hey, what's up guys? Jeremy here from RoboDK. It's time for us to release a new CAD to PAD plugin. Today, we are adding our first Siemens product, Solid Edge. As with any other CAD plugin, you can use Solid Edge to import parts, points, and curves. For this tutorial, we will cover how to create and import a polishing or sanding path from Solid Edge and transform that into a real robot program using RoboDK. Without further ado, let's start this project. We start this project inside RoboDK. We have a station with two UR robots and a base to link them together with the workpiece. In this case, the workpiece is a car hood. There are a few things pre-built in this station. Two small programs bringing each robot back to their home and work positions, a reference frame called frame polishing, which includes the part, and finally we have two polishing tools from Fur Robotics. We'll talk about these tools later. So the goal here is to polish or sand the top surface of that car part. We could think of many different strategies, or many different paths if you like, to polish that part. For this tutorial, we will concentrate on one simple option, simply going up and down the part. I can unhide the paths I created when preparing that video to give you a better idea of what I mean by up and down. On the other half of the part, we could also have selected a side-by-side approach. In this case, the Solid Edge plugin will be the key to create and import these paths. One thing that we need to keep in mind is that the polishing tool needs to be normal to the surface of the part at all time if you want to obtain a good surface finish. We also need to keep a constant force between the tool and the part. This is where the Fur Robotics tool comes handy. It will make sure that the sanding tool will apply just the right amount of force according to the requirements of the car manufacturer. Okay, now that we've covered the RoboDK station, I can delete these two paths and switch to Solid Edge. Okay, so here we have our part to polish. Before looking at it, let's take a look at Solid Edge toolbar. If Solid Edge was already installed on your computer when you installed RoboDK, you should see this tab here. This is RoboDK's plugin. You can see this tab as a bridge between Solid Edge and RoboDK. This bridge lets you load parts, point, and curves from here to RoboDK. If you don't see this tab, don't worry. I'll leave a link in the description of this video. It will include a step-by-step on how to install this plugin. Before using the plugin, we need to do a few things in the software. So I will go back to the Home tab. Okay, and back to the part. As we have two robots in our station, we will attack each half of the part individually. So let's start with the upper one. RoboDK's plugin can import curves from your part. The curves can either be edges, 2D sketches, or different kinds of 3D sketches. For this specific case, the part is curved, and we need to follow that surface here. Therefore, we need to create a projection of the path on that surface. Let's see how we can create that path. First, you need to create a plane on top of the surface to polish. I already created one here, but you can create your own using these tools here. In this case, my plane is parallel to the XY plane. If I'm normal to my plane, I can see a good portion of the part. So what I can do now is create a 2D sketch on that plane and then project it on the surface. I will start by simply drawing a line across the part. Here, it doesn't matter if the line exceeds the dimensions of the part. In fact, it's a good thing. Let's place it at 30 millimeters from the center of the part. Then you can use the rectangular pattern tool to replicate this line every time you want to create a new polishing line. Here, the diameter of our tool is 120 millimeters, and let's say that we need a 50% overlap on each pass. That means that we need 60 millimeters between the passes. Okay, so this is the sketch of our path before projecting it on the surface. As you can see, the sketch is not attached to the surface. Now go to the Surfacing tab, select the Project tool, select the sketch you want to project on the surface, select the surface and the direction. Okay, and now we have our projected path. You can hide the sketch in the plane you used. That's nice. It's obviously a very simple pattern for the purpose of this tutorial, but nonetheless, let's import it to RoboDK. So open the RoboDK tab. First, open the settings, and we need to fill two little things. The name of the curve you will import, so how it will be called inside RoboDK. I called it Polishing Path Top. You also need to give the name of the reference frame in which you want to import the path. In this case, the frame is called Frame Polishing. Take note that its position needs to match the origin of the part in Solid Edge. Here is the origin of the part, so both the reference frame and this origin should match. Okay, I invite you to take a look around and play a bit with the settings. Those can be very useful in certain situations. Okay. Let's import the path. So select load curve, then select the lines you wish to import. It's easier to do so if you hold Ctrl, as it won't let you select faces or other features. Okay, now the path is selected, but we need to provide more information to RoboDK. We need to provide a tool orientation. Release Ctrl and select the surfaces you would like the tool to be normal to. In this case, I need to select both surfaces underneath the path, this one and that one. Okay, now click Done. It can take a few seconds to compute depending on the complexity of the path. Now let's go back to RoboDK. The path was imported at the right position in the frame polishing. It also created a curve follow project. I can open it and simulate the path. The red X here means the path couldn't automatically be solved. Let's simulate to see why. Doesn't look like we selected the right robot configuration to start the path. So let's stop that and let's fix this problem. Bring the robot back to the work position. Okay. In the curve follow project, you can see the preferred joints for start point. You don't need to be super precise, just bring the robot to a configuration that makes sense. Like here at the work position. And click set current. It will record the robot joints value and use that as a reference starting point. Now if I update, the path computes. And I can simulate. As you can see, we still have a few things to fix. The small lines at the bottom of the part should be part of the main polishing passes. To fix that, click Select Curves and select Reset Selection. You can then start selecting your path in your preferred order. If needed, you can also right-click the selected path and reverse direction. Once the path is selected, you can click Done and update the path. And here that path was solved successfully. This is perfect. Approach and retract movements were automatically created at the beginning and at the end of each lines. So in this case, we only need the first and last one here and there. The path between the lines can simply be a move L. So to remove those, just uncheck the approach retract each curve. I can also change the speed of these movements. So go to Param Events, fast move speed. 1,000 millimeters per second is quite fast, so let's drop that to, let's say, 100 millimeters per second. I can also modify the shape of the approach and retract movements. Let's use here an arc normal for the approach and for the retract. And finally, we can set the polishing speed at 100 millimeters per second also. Okay, now update and simulate. That's good. If I'm satisfied with the result, I can close this window. And just below the curve follow project, a new program was generated. You can double click on it to make sure it's the right one. So yeah, this is what I was expecting. Once your simulation is completed, RoboDK can translate the path to a real robot program. To do so, right click the program and select Generate Robot Program. After a few seconds, this window will appear. The program can be uploaded directly on the robot controller. This one is a script file for the universal robots, but RoboDK can generate robot program for the vast majority of the robots brands we have in our library. As you can see in the program, a lot of movements are required to keep a constant orientation between the tool and the part surface. Okay, now before we leave, this was obviously a pretty simple path, but if we go back to Solid Edge, I prepared two more paths for us. Let's hide the one we made together and show the sketch for this one. It's similar to the one we made, but this time it's a continuous path from here to there. So if I use the projection tool on this sketch, I end up with this path here. I could also decide to go side by side with this sketch, and ending up with this path here. Okay, now I have both paths for both my robots. That's very nice. Okay, now I have one last trick to show you guys. Instead of selecting the lines manually one by one, select the projection you made before clicking on Load Curve. It will simply save you time by auto-selecting the curve for you. You simply need to select the faces afterwards. Okay, done. And as you can see, in RoboDK, our path is already imported. This is exactly how I created this complete example here. Okay, that's pretty much everything for today's video. I hope it was helpful. If you think it was, please subscribe to the YouTube channel. And while you're here, leave a thumbs up. If you have any technical question, feel free to visit our forum at robodk.com/forum. We'll be happy to help you. Have a great day, guys.